Hey everyone, I'm doing a workshop series on learning tunes on the fly. It's starting Wednesday after Thanksgiving, and I thought I'd do a little demonstration to show you all what you can expect to learn. So here is me learning a tune on the fly. I opened up slipperyhill.com, slippery-hill.com. Thank you so much to Slippery Hill. And I'm gonna pull up one of these, I think it's like Brandywine 89. They have all these recordings. So I'm just gonna pick a random tune, then I'm going to try to learn it on the fly. And it's not gonna be totally random. I'm specifically gonna try to pick a tune that I've never played before. And I'll take you through my process of learning how to do it. Okay, this'll be fun, or maybe a train wreck, I don't know. Okay, so I've never heard of this tune, Midland Two-Step before. Who's playing? Plywood Cattle Company. That is the artist here. Okay, let's take a listen. First, I gotta figure out what key it's in. Some jingling. Sounds like it's a D tune. So I'm gonna get into D real quick. I'll pause the video while I do that. Da, da, da. Okay, I am in D, so let's resume this recording here. Tell you about my process for learning that. So what I heard in this is that it's what I listened for first after figuring out what key it was in. This is a square tune, so there are a predictable amount of beats, a square amount of beats in the A part and in the B part. It also doesn't have much of a range. It stays kind of just in this one little spot. I found the first note. That's a, when I think about that note, I think of that as a Mi. I'm not necessarily thinking F sharp. I'm thinking, oh, that's the third. That is the sweet major note. That is the note that makes it a major tune. So I hear that first, and I know that I can find that here through my experience jamming and through my like ear training, and we'll cover how to like hear the major third as opposed to like hearing the one or hearing the four or things like that. And then it kind of just sounds like a chord progression tune. It's a little bit more of a chord progression than a fiddle melody. So I'm listening for the anchor notes. In the A part, it's da 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 da. So if a phrase ends on da da na na na, it's probably like signaling a five chord. So I'm gonna play a five chord, and then da. That's our next note. That note is almost always going to be signaling a four chord. Da 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 da. And then I'm just making a bunch of kind of educated guesses, you know? It's like 1 and 5, 4 and 1, 1 and 5, 4 and 1. It's pretty simple. It just stays the course, landing those chords in those predictable spots in the measure, you know, dividing it up into four. So that's what I'm listening to for this. And then I know the B part is going to be different. Usually B parts, if it's a fiddle tune, it's probably going to go high. Like fiddle tunes often like to go up to the highest note in whatever their like main position is. So, you know, they like to play that B note more often than not, in my experience, anecdotally. It's obviously lots of exceptions. So, so I hear that high note. I know that it's probably going to be a one chord over that note. And then I hear that energy shift. Thing that I think it's the same chord progression for this part. It's just a higher version of it. It's almost like the melody in the B part is a harmonized version of the melody in the A part. So that's how I'm thinking about it. And when I'm listening for those chord changes, I'm specifically listening for anchor notes of the chords. So I know that T wants to go to Do, the 7 wants to go to 1, and Fa, the 4, wants to go down to Mi. And you might be thinking, like, how do you know that's what the note is? Well, it's because we all know intuitively that chords hold different amounts of tension and release, or else we wouldn't feel anything when we listen to, you know, Western music that is built on those asymmetries in the scale. And, you know, we all know that that's not done. It needs to resolve. And specifically, it matters where it resolves. Like, that technically resolves, but it resolves wrong. We want it to go... We're all trained to know this intuitively. It's just a matter of connecting it with our instrument and connecting it with our ear and making those connections. You know, if you can feel things in while you're listening to music, it means that you understand what is going on, because, yeah, a lot of the emotive energy and like tension and release of a lot of music, not all old time music, a lot of it doesn't play by these rules, but it at least flirts with them a little bit. If you understand what's going on, then you can identify it's like, oh, there's a shift in energy here. It got slightly more tense and then really tense. It probably means it went from a 4 to a 5. And if it went from a 4 to a 5, there are only a couple notes that the fiddle tune is likely, you know, playing to dictate those chord changes, and I can help you like figure out what those notes are. More often than not, it's just like one note signals a 4, one note signals a 5, and we'll be going over all that kind of stuff in this workshop. Yeah, there's still a lot of time to sign up. Looks like we got like 15 people coming, which is like my biggest workshop series yet. I'm really excited for that. So I hope to see some of y'all there. I hope we get a few more. I think Discord will hold up to like 25 or something. So there's still some more spots. I would love to have more of you out there, and we'll get into how to listen and not just be overwhelmed and not to just noodle, but to listen critically and then to jump in quickly. Yeah, so I got a lot of ideas about that, and let's get into it. And in the meantime, check out Plywood Cattle Company. That was such a lovely little recording. I haven't really dug into these like Brandywine recordings that are here on Slippery Hill. And they're like full recordings, not just like tiny little snippets. So thanks Slipper Hill for your wonderful resource. What would we do without you? Okay. See you soon. Sign up CameronDewitt.com/store. There's a link in the thing, or if you're watching this on Instagram, in my bio.